In beer, we have four main ingredients: water, malt, hops, and yeast. When we think about malt, which comes from barley, we have three main components that are important to beer: carbohydrates, proteins, and lipids. Carbohydrates give us the sugars that the yeast are converting to ethanol. The proteins are important for the health of the yeast, but also the enzymes that are going to be breaking down these sugars, and also some flavor components. The lipids are usually overlooked, but they're also important to the health of the yeast. And if we do not have a good profile of lipids, we will have a problem with the yeast having to create their own lipids to create cell walls, which will slow down our primary fermentation. We have to be careful because too many fatty acids from our lipids also cause problems. So we want just the right amount, but not too much. So what are lipids? If we look at lipids, there's two main areas: complex lipids, which contain fatty acids, such as triglycerides, waxes, and phospholipids. We also have simple lipids. These are simple hydrocarbon compounds, such as steroids, prostaglandins, and terpenes. Fatty acids are called that because they have a carboxylic acid group and a long carbon chain. This sets up a dynamic where we have a polar head group, the carboxylic acid, and a nonpolar tail. This gives it a very characteristic behavior. If we think about the fatty acid, if we deprotonate it, we can form a carboxylate group, which makes it even more polar. This will give us a surfactant product, such as soap. This will change the behavior. Fatty acids are important not only to the health of the yeast, but also properties such as foam retention. The fatty acids are part of the triglycerides. Triglycerides, we have a glycerin molecule with three fatty acids attached. A wax is going to be a fatty acid and a long chain alcohol. And our phospholipids. Our phospholipids are often very similar to our triglycerides, but there's going to be a phosphate group. These are important in membranes, so phospholipid membranes are important to cell walls. Our smaller lipids, such as our steroids, prostaglandins, and terpenes, do not have fatty acids. Here is a common steroid in fungi or yeast, ergosterol. If we see here, a steroid has a very specific ring structure, 3 6-membered rings and a 5-membered ring. Prostaglandins are created from our fatty acids. They always contain a 5-membered group. If we see here, we can see the carboxylic acid group. On one end, we see our 5-membered group, and we will have 20 carbons. Our last lipid form is our terpenes. Although the terpenes that come from our malt are a very, very minor constituent to the final flavors, the terpenes we get from hops are going to be essential. Here we see humulene. Humulene is a major component of the flavor components we're going to get from our hops. Lipids are a small component when we discuss the chemistry of beer, but they're essential to the health of our yeast and some of the mouthfeel and head retention that is very characteristic for beer.